Dear ladies and guests, for today's function, respected Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi ji, Dr. Devi Shetty ji, author Sri Rajendra Gupta ji, Mr. Tering ji, dear friends, good evening, namaste. I am glad that my friend Rajendra Gupta ji has done extensive research on healthcare reforms and come out with this book, which is not just very timely, but it is a seminal work. The most interesting part of that, he has covered all the aspects of the healthcare. He has gone in depth to explore how we must the positioning of our most revered system of Ayurveda over time, and he has also made suggestion on how to rejuvenate Ayurveda. The year 2015 signals the turning point in the field of medicine and healthcare. First major things was the acceptance of yoga and its benefit, which happened due to the efforts of our Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi ji, when the world accepted June 21st as the International Day of Yoga. Second most important development was the announcement of the Nobel Prize in Physiology or Medicine to Chinese scientist Yu Yu Tu, who isolated artemisinin in validate and a useful treatment for malaria. This is a radical shift, and for India, it means a lot, as India is the world leader since ages in the both this field. We are the land that gives the two major gifts to mankind, Ayurveda and Yoga. We also will have to work the hardest to give this system their right place. Rajendra Gupta ji has very well documented in this book how Ayurveda was suffocated with the planned approach. In this book, his quote, "It is an interesting fact that we have continued to ignore the merit of the system of the fact that Kerala has been able to have better health indicator despite having shortage of doctors, as 40-50% of this population must be seeking health care through the traditional medicine rather than allopathic medicine." Rajan Gupta ji further quote in this book, "In India, Ayurveda was highly successful and the British feared about it. If we did into history, we can clearly figure out that a single point agenda was to promote the allopathic medicine and create the suspicion about the efficacy of the Ayurveda. In fact, he mentioned about the reason for the decline in indigenous system, which were due to the decline in standard of living due to the excessive land revenue demands and de-skilling of Indian healers as they were deprived of the local patronage. Folk medicine was finally treated like a fake medicine. They followed a strategy to ensure that Western medicine took the top slot when it came to the medical practices, and the indigenous system were downgraded in the eye of the care seeker when compared to the practitioners of Western medicine. On one side, the British discouraged the indigenous medicine, but Europeans did extensive study into Ayurveda through the practitioners, and after assimilating a good deal of knowledge, distanced themselves from it. In this book, Rajendra Gupta ji mentioned 85-90% of the ailment can be handled with the primary care approach by Indian system of medicine as done by China. We also need to take a clue from Singapore, where health expenditure has remained between 3-4% of GDP compared to OECD's 9%. Singapore's healthcare system is related amongst the best in the world, and it is interesting to note the role of traditional Chinese practitioners, who sees 12% of all the OPD patients daily. Let me also share with you some of the achievements of our Ayush ministry since its formation. We have created two Guinness World Records when 35,985 participants made the largest yoga session and 84 nationalities present led to the maximum nationalities in the single yoga session. Outside India, the first International Yoga Day was celebrated all over the world, except Yemen, by the Ministry of External Affairs with association with Ministry of Ayush and various organizations. Ministry of Ayush has been conducting Yoga Week yoga training program for the various government employees across the country. We have developed a scheme with Quality Council of India for voluntary certification of yoga professionals. National Ayush Mission is a turning point, and it will help the better access to the Ayush service through the various initiatives. We have made important strides in international arena. The 8th ministerial meeting of the India-US Trade Policy Forum, wherein the United States agreed to facilitate the further engagement in this field. Our bilateral initiative with the United States now includes complementary and traditional medicine. Similarly, we have had bilateral engagement and exchange with other countries which also cover Ayush. The Ministry of Ayush has set up an information cell in Beijing, Dubai, Stockholm, Sweden, Croatia and Latvia to disseminate the authentic information about the Ayush system of medicine. As a first breakthrough in the European University, an Ayurveda chair has been set up by the Ministry of Ayush. The ministry produced and telecast 10 episodes of an interactive TV program that is Ayushman Bharat through Doordarshan in Hindi and regional languages. The ministry organized the 6 national and 6 state level Arogya Fairs across India. A pilot project on homeopathy for a healthy child for health promotion and treatment of the common disease among the children has been launched in 6 districts. An integration of homeopathy, Ayurveda and Unani in the national program for prevention and control of cancer, diabetes, CBD and stroke program in 6 districts has been approved by the DGS. Project on aerogenomics has been initiated. Pharmacopeial monographs on single drug and compound formulation of Ayurvedic system of medicine, Ayurveda, Unani, Siddha and homeopathy has been developed. Upgrading the Department of Ayush to a full-fledged ministry by the Honorable Prime Minister underlines his vision and recognition of the potential of importance of Ayush both in India and global context. Launching of National Ayush Mission by the present government and UN Declaration of International Yoga Day and its successful celebration across the globe have drawn national and international attention towards the emerging prospects of Ayush in healthcare. Besides this, we are working on many other initiatives. Rajan Gupta ji has suggested some very innovative ideas in this book. And we both have been discussing about way to rejuvenate Ayurveda and mainstream it. Indigenous system have to become a forward-looking and most importantly address the issue of outcome validation studies to reclaim its place. Ayurveda, yoga, not just a line of treatment, but if we really wish to achieve health as per the WHO definition, which states that health is a state of complete physical, mental, and social well-being, and not merely the absence of disease or infirmity. We will need to go back to the basic of Ayurveda and yoga. Of course, we have a lot of work to do to scientifically validate Ayurveda, and we are committed to ensure that we mainstream Ayush. Enormous information, fact, and dates are in this book, and I'm sure that the insight are of immense value to people who work in this area of health and healthcare. People who read this book will for sure get enlightened on not just the traditional system of medicine, but at all aspect of health and healthcare. Thank you for hearing me and having me here. Congratulated Mr. Rajan Gupta ji once again for this book. Thank you very much. Namaste.